Hello, I'm Mike. Continue the previous video, part 3. In today's video, I shall demonstrate the steps on how to create a VBA procedure to save file with naming conventions according to the inputs given by user. If you like watch more videos from my channel, please press subscribe button below. In previous video, we have created an Excel template to let user give the customer info and contact info as the tags for their analysis. By project requirement, this info should be embedded as naming conventions into template file name for later reporting purpose. We may create the VBA procedure as one-click button to consolidate it and embed the info into the file name automatically. Before the creation in VBA editor, let's unlock the front page sheet with the previous assigned password. Under Developer tab, open the VBA editor with password. Find the main modular to add the new procedure. Let's name the procedure as a CMD save file. First, we define two string variables. One is for hosting folder path name, one is for hosting file name. Secondly, select the target front page sheet to activate. Thirdly, we need to collect all key inputs from the sheet and store them into the file name variable, such as region name from a front page, cell G10, account name from the cell G11, account contact name from the G19, sales representative from G20, attach the timestamp to the file name. With year, month, date, hour, and minutes. And with the file extension .xlsm. Finally, to call FileDialog object and utilize the FileDialog property to take the argument SaveAs DialogType for providing user a file dialog box to save selected file. With using the application FileDialog object and take the argument SaveAs DialogType, close bracket, set the dialog object property and now multi-select as false because we only allow to select the single file. Set the property FileIndex as 2, which is the default type of the file XLSM. The property initial file name should be the destination path string given by user and plus file name. Here the input of the destination path string comes from the cell G15. And in the codeline, I made a minor error with an additional letter S in the end of the sheet. And I shall show how to debug it in our testing phase. Move on, use the property initial view, displays the initial presentation details of folder and files in the file dialog box for user. Now we reach the step to apply method to save file. Use the method show to return the long value -1 or 0, which indicates if user press action button or cancel button. Then based on the return value to call execute method to save user selection or quit the procedure. close the vscore by endvis. By this phase, we have completed the save file procedure creation. Last step is to create the one-click save file button in the front page tab. And make a reminder notes for user to save the template by pressing the button. It is time to do a test with the created procedure. Press the save file button. We have a debug warning message. It tells there is an error with the error type 424 and an object is missing. We may press help button to get more hints about the error type in details. Let's click the debug button. It brings us to the highlighted codeline. After checking, we found a spelling error on sheet object. Clear the additional S and run the code again. It went through and bring us to the file save dialog box. Clean the debug process and rerun the test from the beginning. In path folder box, we have a predefined root path C driver only. Press the save file button. It brings us to the C drive for choosing subfolder. Choose the users slash public and then save the file. In the destination subfolder, we can find the file names with account info, contact info, and timestamps. The procedure also allows us to give a predefined folder path to save file. Let's choose a subfolder, users, / use as a predefined path and fill it into the folder path box in front page tab. Click the save button. It brings us to the target folder users use to save the file. Save. The file is saved successfully and the target subfolder. Lastly, let's clean the all inputs in the file. Protect the front page tab with password. Save it as a clean template for future using. That is all about how to create the VBA procedure to save file with naming convention according to the inputs given by users. Thanks for your watching. If you like to watch more videos from the channel, please press the subscriber button in below. See you in next video.